Hi and welcome to the LA1 show. I'm Claire.
And I'm Rob. There's been lots going on around campus recently. Second term has been very busy and we've gone to see some of the things going on. We travelled all the way to the top of campus to the Great Hall,
where the Culture Society has put on a show with the performances from the cheerleaders, Ludance and many more.
In my opinion, it's the best way to end the Global Village Week.
On the 6th of March, both campus celebrities and ballroom professionals took to the floor in the Great Hall, right to the side of me, where they took part in the Strictly Charity Showcase.
The event raised over £1,500 for cancer research. The couples trained over a 2-month period and they all worked very, very hard, but there was always going to be only one winner. And this year, it was Mike and Rihanna.
So while you watch the winning performance, we're going to go watch some of the show.
On the first page of a story, the future seemed so bright. Then this thing turned out so evil. I don't know why I'm still surprised. Even angels had their wicked schemes, and you take that to new extremes. But you'll always
Hi, we're here in the Great Hall with a member of the Ludance who has just performed in the Culture Society show. How did that go for you?
It was really well, thank you. We performed our inter-ballet routine, which is one of our competition squad routines. We performed at Durham Dance Fusion in first term with that routine and placed second. So it was great to perform it again.
Yeah, did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was really good, really good.
I'm aware you've got a show coming up. How are the rehearsals going?
Rehearsal's going really well, thanks. We've been rehearsing since week one of this term and we've got about 70 to 80 members of the society involved doing 37 dances, so it's quite a lot, but really good. Lots of different styles, from your regular like ballet, tap, jazz, street, to Irish tap. We've got burlesque, so lots of variety, so it's a lot for everyone.
Which is your favourite?
That's a tough question. I'm in quite a few, so I'm not going to say, but our show is on Thursday, Friday and Saturday, which is the 5th, 6th and 7th of March in the Nothing Theatre at 7:30, and you can book your tickets now from www.liveatleica.org.
Book your tickets now.
We're here with two people from the Cultural Society exec, and so how did tonight's show go then?
Well, it was good. There was quite a number of people who attended and like they were greeted with some free food before the performance and they sat through like an hour of good performancing. basically.
Minor technical setbacks, but nothing big. Like, the show went really smoothly, so we're really happy with how it turned out.
Oh, that's great. And do you know, on average, how long it took you to prepare for this show?
Well, it took some time. Basically, at least this whole term was spent to prepare for it. And all the previous, like, exec meetings, we've been primarily preparing for this event.
Like, yeah, we started talking about this during the first term. We've prepared it, and there was quite a few meetings about it. The budget was actually a really hard part to organize.
It's quite an expensive event, to be honest.
Yeah, the venue was quite expensive. But overall, like, the preparation went pretty smoothly. Long, definitely long, and a lot of work, especially from the president. Props to her.
She was the hard worker.
Well, it's all paid off. Well, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you for coming.
No problem. And some of the LA1 crew went down to Warwick last week to film the Unibrass competition,
in which Lancaster did very, very well. They came fourth.
You think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew, you never knew. Thank you.
Ashley, what are you doing? Ashley, what are you doing? Oh my God. Ashley is our second cornet player, and he's always wanted to conduct, and we've always said no, but it looks like today might be his lucky day. This is Max Stannard's North and South, Movement 3, Songs of the Union.
We are at Grisel Bar, in which the Bulgarian society has taken over.
There has been all sorts going on tonight, with traditional Bulgarian food to traditional Bulgarian music.
Last month, LA1 TV filmed the Live at Laika, the band that Jack built.
The concert was a celebration of dance band leader and theatre great Jack Hilton's life. And it featured Michael Law's Piccadilly Dance Orchestra. Let's go take a look.
And there's a great event going on tonight. It's a music event. I think it might be Pendle Live.
But one more time for Nikita! His first time at Pendle Live Go, that was pretty special, really well done. So a flat battery walks into a bar. And the barman says, for you, no charge.
Well, that was exceptional. She's very, very talented, isn't she?
Yeah, very talented. And with all those jokes, you would have thought we were back in county.
Yeah. The CCO Women's Liberation, Catherine Chantel, has been going around campus asking everyone who inspires them the most out of women and why.
Hi, I'm Caitlin, and this is Omena, and we're both Liberation Officers for LUSU. And today we're asking which woman inspires us.
I'd probably say Laura Clayson.
I'm inspired by Claire Jowett. She's an academic in Literary and Cultural Studies.
I'm inspired by a woman called Emma Smith, and she lived in 1800s, and she was really powerful. She went through a lot, but she stood firm.
A woman that inspired me, I think, is Esther in the Bible, because of her courage and the strength that she has to stand up for what she knows, right?
Quite a bit of history. The only really one of the big women who inspired me was Florence Nightingale.
Yeah, I definitely will say my mom.
I'd have to say my nan, because she's gone through a lot and she's just remained like so strong.
Ever since I've been little, I've always been really inspired by Lois Lane from the Superman comics, because not only is she a kick-ass reporter, she's a Pulitzer Prize winner, she's a woman in what's traditionally been like a very male-dominated profession, and also she can go toe-to-toe with like the world's leading superpowers, supervillains, and like presidents and everything.
Emily Pankhurst, because she had the conviction to fight for what she believed in.
J.K. Rowling, because she isn't afraid to be opinionated, and regardless of whether that opinion goes with social pressure or not.
Cheesy, I know, but definitely my mum.
Judith Butler.
Why?
Because I find her theories interesting sociologically. She's a top lass.
My mum, and she inspires me because she's an extremely hard worker, and she got far in her life, and I want to go far in my life, so yeah.
For me, it's Josie Harrison. She's one of my friends, and she's currently directing Vagina Monologues on campus, which I'm part of, which is a great program. So yeah, it would be Josie Harrison.
Yeah, Chloe Handsome, because she's a beautiful girl, and she's very talented, many different ways.
My mum.
And why?
Because she's strong and she's taught me lots of stuff, and she knows how to cook, and she's been through a lot of stuff, but she's got out the other end of it. It's admirable.
My mother inspires me quite a lot.
My mother, because she's really strong, she's really supportive, she's very dedicated to a lot of different things, and I wouldn't be where I am without her.
Apart from my mum, there's Mallory Blackman, because she wrote inspirational books at the time called Noughts and Crosses, about kind of race relations. There's Frida Kahlo, because she's an amazing artist, and she was also kind of, she defied boundaries with her art in terms of gender, politics, sexuality.
J.K. Rowling, not only because of her fabulous books, but also for her charity work as well. So that kind of, she does so much for writing and mental health as well with, I think it's Lumos.
That would be the female vocalist from Skillet, my favourite band.
At the moment it's my flatmate Leah, because she really wanted to go to New York after graduation, but none of her friends from home or something would go with her, so she just decided to go by herself, and she's planned it all out and she's just going for it.
A woman who inspires me is Margaret Thatcher. I think she's a very strong woman. She
had very good opinions, very strong opinions. She inspired a lot of people, not necessarily, you know, she didn't necessarily do what was right or anything. But.
Probably Maya Angelou, because she went through racism and sexism throughout her entire life and she still came out on top.
So, we've been all around campus, now we're back where we started after a great night.
And there's been a lot going on around campus recently, and there's going to be even more going on towards the end of this term.
Make sure you watch our next episode, which is going to be a Campus Fest special.
Yep, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time. Goodbye.
Goodbye.